Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another Tuesday. Today, we are going to be talking about hand sewing. Woo. So I actually had a request to do my snuggle sack video, which I will link in the description and I'll like put it up here or whatever, to show how to sew that by hand. So I thought, hey, you know what I need to do? A video on how to sew by hand. I'm just going to kind of roll the two into one. I'm going to teach you three hand stitches that you should know as a sewist, whether you have a machine or not. Hi, I'm Nikita, and welcome to my channel where this is what I do. I drink and I sew things. So today I've got my Rosie the Riveter glass, which is awesome, but I have a new beer to try, you guys. Okay, if you have ever been to Trader Joe's, there is this thing that's called speculoos. Is that how you pronounce it? Cookie butter? Oh my gosh. It's like Nutella or something, but it's made out of cookies. It is absolutely delicious. Can you hear that dog barking? It is absolutely delicious. So I thought, oh my gosh, they made a beer out of it. So I'm gonna try it. I'm so excited. I do like to pour aggressively. I feel like it gets some of the bubbles out of the way, you know, so that when you drink it, it's not as like, you know, in your tummy. What was that? Ooh. A couple months ago, I tried their ginger beard stout. This has some of the same flavors, I think. It does kind of remind me of a cookie. Yum. Okay, so today I'm teaching you three hand stitches. Number one is the running stitch, which is kind of your general all-purpose putting things together stitch. Number two is the invisible stitch, which is good for closing holes or patching things up where you don't want to see your seam. Number three is the back stitch, which will actually give you a continuous seam. It's like a hand embroidery stitch, but if you're trying to do a top stitch to make something look real pretty, this might be the one for you. So let's talk about what you need. Now for hand sewing, you're going to need some hand needles. Now there are different sizes of hand needles. I believe actually all three of these are the same size. The size of the needle is going to tell you how big this part is, which is called the shaft, and a bigger needle will also often have a larger eye, which is the hole in the top. You're going to need thread. I would use a matching color, but I'm going to use a contrasting color so that it is easier for you to see on my project. You are also going to want scissors or snips of some kind. First, I'm going to take a length of thread. I'm probably gonna go with, I don't know, quite a bit. But the way I like to do this to give myself a stronger thread and to make it easier is I usually double it up so it ends up being half of the length that you actually cut. So if you're doing it this way, then if you cut what I just did, which is about 36 inches, then now it's actually only going to be about 18 inches worth of thread. Let's talk about threading a needle. The first way to thread a needle, obviously, is to find the eye of the needle and push that thread through. Then we're going to pull it, and then we're going to meet up the two ends. And I'll show you how to tie a knot in just a second. The other way to do it is with something that's called a needle threader. This is what it looks like. And it comes in a lot of these kind of basic sewing, beginner sewing packs. So it looks like this, where it's this kind of flimsy, like foil thing, but it has this wire here at the end with a little loop. So you're going to take your needle threader and we're going to push it through the eye of the needle, which is the little hole there on top. You're going to push it all the way through to the base of the needle threader. Okay, you may have to squeeze this little part right here that sticks out a little bit. Then you are going to pass your thread through that part, wire part of the needle threader. Okay, I'm going to pull it through a couple inches. And then you're simply just going to pull the needle threader out and the thread will come with it. And now I have a threaded needle. I don't know if you've seen the sewing hack where you put the thread over your hand,
then put the needle, the eye of the needle on top, and then you rub the eye of the needle back and forth on the string. And it's supposed to pick up the thread, and it's supposed to be really easy. However, I have never been able to get it to work. So if you want to try this method, there may be a trick to it. I don't know. You can go ahead and try it out on your own, but I'm going to use one of my other two methods. Now that you've got it threaded, we're going to talk about how to knot the end of the thread. So I pulled my thread all the way through my needle. So now I have the two ends that are meeting up. My thread is doubled up. So the two ends of my thread are mostly meeting together. There are lots of ways to knot a thread, and I'm going to show you the way that I do it. So I take my thread and I make a loop in the bottom couple inches of the thread. Like this. So now the thread is on top. Okay, I'm actually going to make that a little bit, the actual loop a little bit smaller. So then the tail is about an inch or an inch and a half. Now I'm going to pass the tail underneath so that it's behind like that. And then what I do is I just pull it and it creates this knot in the thread. And it's fairly thick because it's two layers. So let me show you that again on a different piece of thread. Grab the tail and make a loop. Pass the tail to the back. You pull the tail through just a little bit of that circle. And then you grab that whole thing and just pull down. And it creates this nice little knot. And now finally, we just need to. And now we are ready to sew. When I'm sewing a snuggle sack, the idea is, or really anything, the two pieces of fabric that we're trying to sew together, they go right sides together or pretty sides together. On my hedgehogs, it's actually really hard to tell which side is which. On fleece, usually one side is like really fuzzy, kind of like this, and one side is not quite as fuzzy. It's a lot more obvious on this bee fabric. This side is very vibrant. And this side is much more dull. So we know that this is the wrong side, this is the right side. So we put our right sides together and we are going to sew along these three edges. If we do that, when we turn it right side out, the seam will be on the inside and the pretty side will be on the outside. Now when I begin to sew, I'm gonna start in the corner. And I want my knot to be on the back side of my fabric. So I'm going to push my needle up through the back. Don't pull it too tight because you can pull it all the way through the fabric. So my knot is now on this side. So we're going to start with what is called a running stitch, which is the pretty basic stitch for how to put two pieces of fabric together. But actually, I need to take a drink of my beer. So cheers, my friends. It's very important that you keep that nearby. Then I'm going to put my needle back through the fabric, maybe a quarter of an inch away from where I put it in. And I'm going to pull it through. So now you can see I have one stitch. And on the back, I am going to put it through about a quarter of an inch again. Now, hand sewing, in my opinion, can be a little more difficult than machine sewing because it's a lot easier to mess it up. For example, if I'm starting on the back and I'm going in a quarter of an inch and I put my needle in like this, and it's kind of at an angle, look where it ends up. It is on the inside of this stitch and it's pretty close to where I left off, which it doesn't look like that on this side. So you have to be really careful. I'm just gonna pull that back through. When you put it in, I'm gonna look at the front as I'm putting it in. So I'm gonna put it in, swap it to the front, say, I don't really like the placement of that. So then I'll take it out again, say, okay, I like the placement of that a lot better. And then I'm going to pull it through. Put it in, look to the back. Oh, see, look at this. Sometimes this happens, especially when you're hand sewing. So what I do is I take my needle and look at that. It's not actually a knot, it's just a bunch of bunched up thread. So you just gotta be careful of that, especially when your thread is so long like mine is. That doesn't happen as often when it's shorter. Okay, so I like that placement. So I'm going to pull it through. Okay, and then I'm gonna put it through again. Now you can see my stitches aren't super even. This one is very large, this one here is very small. So how can we fix that? Well, one way is to make two marks on our finger like this. So I put my finger on the fabric and used that as a marker. And now in theory, my stitches should be all the same size. Now you can also see, I kind of started out a little bit farther away here, but I ended up getting a little bit closer to the edge as I am going down. So how do I make sure that my stitches all stay in a straight line using whatever seam allowance I want? Well, one way is to also use the finger trick here. So I can use it as not only a stitch length marker, but I can also use it as a seam allowance marker. Another way, if you have especially a light colored fabric on the wrong side, you can use a pencil, a pen, or a fabric marker and a straight edge to draw a straight line. And then you just sew down that straight line. If you don't want to use a fabric marker, or maybe your fabric is a little bit darker, like this one is, take a piece of painter's tape, and before you begin to sew, take that painter's tape and use a straight edge or a cutting mat like this that has markings on it, and lay that piece of painter's tape where you want that seam allowance, and then sew just on the inside of that tape, and then remove it when you're done. Okay, now here, you see what I've done? I have my thread on this side of my fabric and I've put my needle up through here. What's gonna happen when I pull this through, you can see that it's going to create a knot around my thread and I do not want that. So make sure, pass my needle through there to undo that. Make sure that when you are sewing, put your thread on the side that you're sewing on. So I'm sewing from the back, so it's gonna be on the back. I'm sewing from the front, so it's gonna be on the front. That way it won't get tangled up and you won't accidentally get some unintentional knots. Okay, now let's pretend this is the end. I mean, it's not. I need to keep sewing around all the sides, but let's pretend that this is, I've gotten to the end, and now what do I do? So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna bring my thread back to the front. It doesn't actually have to be on the front, but I like it that way. Now I'm going to go just ahead of my thread. I'm gonna pick up a small amount of fabric with my needle. Now this time, I do want to make that knot like I was making accidentally earlier. So I'm gonna take my needle, I'm gonna pass it through that loop, and then I'm going to pull it tight. Okay. Then I'm going to do it again. I like to go back over the same spot. So it's just like sort of making another stitch. Okay. Now I'm just gonna pass my needle through this thread stuff I've made, put it all the way through, and then just trim the end off. And that, my friends, is a running stitch. I also wanted to show you what it looks like to do a running stitch with just a single piece of fabric instead of trying to go through two layers. So we're gonna start the same, where we make our needle with a knot at the end. We're gonna go up through the back. Okay. I find it easier to go through just one layer because it's easier to keep your stitches even. I also like to just stay on the one side because it's easier for me to see, so I don't have to flip my fabric back and forth. I just kind of blindly poke through the back of the fabric. So you can see it's going very well. So let's talk about things that running stitches are good for. So we use a running stitch to put two pieces of fabric together. We use a running stitch to do top stitching as well. You can also use a running stitch to hand quilt something. And I'm going to show you another thing that a running stitch is good for.
Because let's say that you have like a hole or something, you can do a running stitch around it and then watch what happens when I pull. See, it makes like this little like ruching, is that what it's called? I don't know. So you can also do that. So if you don't want that to happen, then don't pull on your fabric. But I've used that when I have a hole, I do a running stitch around the outside of the hole and then pull so that the fabric cinches around itself. It's like a quick fix for a hole if you need one. Now, how do I tie it off when I don't have two layers of fabric to go through? I just have the one and I don't want to pick up a little bit of fabric because you'll be able to see that on the other side. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pass my needle underneath one of the stitches and then through the loop. I'm not gonna pull it too tight because I don't want it to, you know, cinch. And then I'm gonna do it again so that now I have a knot, and then just clip it. And now you have a nice little running stitch. All right, I wanna show you another trick, because what if I'm doing a running stitch as like a top stitch and I don't want there to be a knot on the back of my fabric? What I do instead, take the two ends of your thread, and we are going to thread both ends through the eye of the needle. Okay, probably works better with a larger eye, and this would be a good time to use your needle threader. I threaded both of the ends through my eye. I'm gonna pull it down a couple of inches because this is where I'm gonna hold on. We're not gonna tie a knot or anything. At the other end of my thread, I have a loop. So let's start like normal by going up through the back. But don't pull it all the way through. Leave the loop like this. Okay, then let's do our first stitch. And I'm gonna put my thumb on the loop so I don't accidentally pull it through. Okay, now pass your needle through the loop to now create this knot. And then if we're doing a running stitch, we're gonna keep going forward just like normal. And now the back of my fabric just has this little loop here that looks much neater than a knot.
Well, once I get my project turned right side out, I generally have this gap here because you have to leave a gap in order to turn it right side out. So we're going to tuck those ends under, and they kind of naturally want to fold under to meet together because of the seam allowance on each side. So we want it eventually to look like this, and we want it to be sewn together, right? Well, I don't like to use a top stitch on my snuggle sacks because I don't want little tiny hamster nails to get stuck in it and stuff. And sometimes you don't want to see a top stitch. Or maybe if you are repairing two quilt blocks that have ripped apart in one of your favorite quilts, you want to just stitch it back together, but you don't want to see kind of all of those stitches. So I'm going to show you how to do an invisible stitch. I am using white thread. You can see that this is contrasting. I am using it because I want you to see what the stitches look like. If I was doing this and not wanting to see it, I wanted it to actually be invisible stitch, then I would use black thread, so that you really couldn't see it. You couldn't see the knot, you couldn't see any of the stuff. So use a matching thread color. That's my advice to you. My other advice to you is make sure you keep your drink nearby. So I'm gonna open up this hole, and then I am right-handed, so everything I'm gonna do is gonna be right-handed. If you're left-handed, just do the opposite, okay? I'm gonna take my right hand, and I'm going to put the needle through the back, a quarter to a half inch away from this top opening here, and I'm going to pull it. Now you can see my knot is on the inside, so I'm never gonna be able to see it. Now I'm actually gonna flip this because I'm going to hold it with my left hand and stitch with my right. I am on the seam line. This is good, this is what you want. You wanna be on the seam line. I'm going to start on one side, doesn't really matter, and I'm going to pick up about a quarter of an inch of fabric. I'm gonna pull that thread tight. Okay, not quite tight though, I'm gonna show you. Directly across from where you ended, you're going to put your needle in again, and you're gonna pick up about the same amount of fabric, about a quarter of an inch. And I'm gonna pull it like this. Okay, so now you can see I have these two these two thread lines. And I'm gonna go directly across, and I'm gonna do the same thing again. Okay, and now I'm going to pull my thread tight, and you can see that the stitches disappear when I do that. You can also hear my cat scratching at the door. I think she wants to come in. I like to pull my thread tight as I go, so it disappears as I go. Obviously, it's not 100% disappearing right now because, well, I'm using a contrasting thread color. And when I pull my thread tight, you can see how it kind of puckers a little bit. I'm just gonna gently ease it apart just a little bit so that I don't quite notice the puckering as much. You wanna do that as you go and not at the very end, and I will tell you why. I like to go just one or two stitches past the end of the opening. Okay, I'm gonna pull it tight. You can see my thread has basically disappeared. So now this is how I end it. I'm going to take up a tiny piece of fabric in the middle and push my needle through. Just like the other ones, I'm going to put the needle through the loop and pull it tight to create a knot. I'm gonna do the same thing again, trying to end up in about the same area so that those two knots are the same size, okay? Then let's push our thread through what we just did. Pull that through there and then cut it close. And now if this was matching, you wouldn't really be able to see this. If you gently tug it, sometimes it'll also disappear. I like to use a needle to kind of push it down there into the gap so it disappears a little bit more. Now what happens if you get to the end and you say, oh, this is puckered, I don't really like that, and you pull it, what can happen is that the knot that you made here will slip out and then you will undo all the work that you did. Not like I know that from experience or anything. And that, my friends, is an invisible stitch. The last stitch I'm gonna show you is called a back stitch. Now while I tie my knot, I'm gonna tell you what you use a back stitch for. So you can use it to do a top stitch instead of the running stitch if you want. But this is actually like a hand embroidery stitch, so you can use it for quilting. You can also use it for putting shapes and letters on your fabric. So when I'm doing shapes or letters, I like to use a pencil or a fabric marker, or you can use chalk to draw the shape or draw the letters. And then I am going to pick a place to start. I'm going to start in this point here of the heart. I'm going to go up from the back until my knot gets stopped. Now let's pick a direction to go. We'll go to the left. We're going to put our needle in just like the beginning of a running stitch, except now I'm going to go back up through the back as if I were going to do a running stitch again and keep going. But instead of continuing to go forward, I'm going to go back, put my needle in right at the end of that first stitch. See? So it's like a running stitch, except that I'm filling in the gaps. I'm gonna put my needle in again ahead of my last stitch. And then I'm going to go backwards again, doing a back stitch to fill in. Whoops, that wasn't as straight as maybe I wanted it. That's okay. Now you can see I've only got like 3 or 4 inches of thread left, and this is about where I want to stop, because otherwise I won't have enough room to, you know, put my needle through and then put it back through the loop that I make. So when I have about this much is when I decide to tie it off. So I am going to go back to the back side of my fabric because I don't want my knot on the front. So similar to the running stitch, we're going to pass our needle through just the thread and not through the fabric, and then pass your needle through the loop that you make. Don't pull too tight. And then let's do that again. and then cut it off. So here's like a third of a heart. So I would then put some more thread in my needle, and then I would start here and then just pick it up and then keep going and then tie it off again once I get back to this point. And that is a back stitch.
And that there, my friends, is three hand stitches that you need to know. So now if your sewing machine takes a crap on you, or maybe you don't have a sewing machine, then you know now how to patch things up and sew some stuff together. To be honest, I'm not very good at doing that. I'm just so out of practice. I've been relying on my machine to do all of that for me. Well, I hope you learned something here today. And even if you didn't, I hope that you had as good of a time as I did. Woo! Well, if you enjoyed this video, I don't know why I'm standing like this. If you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate it if you would like and subscribe so that you can be in the know about my next upcoming video series, which is going to be a beginner series on choosing a sewing machine and basic projects to teach you how to use it. So stick around. You can drink along and sew along with me on my next video. Thanks for watching. Ooh. I should get this again. Pretty good.